Disney presents
The Wonderful World of
Doctor, there's one in the village.
It's too late for a doctor. My student, Richard Evans. Gotta talk to him.
But you need help. You
please hurry.
Michael, get Dr. Ward. Boy C doesn't move. right, then. Come on, keep it moving. Yes, over here.
Well, that's not too bad at all, Rich.
Well, I owe it all to you, Sean.
Wait till you see O'Shaughnessy play tomorrow. You'll never see the likes of it again.
I thought you said Riley was the best hurling player you'd ever seen.
Oh, that was last month.
Oh. Master Evans! There's a man out front wants to talk to you. I'm afraid he's dying. Richard Evans?
Well, yes, sir, I am.
It's important I speak to you. Alone. You must get a message. Brother Tom, you must tell no one else what I'm going to say. No one. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Point. Castle. My room. The Andiron. The information's there. Everything.
Dead. Brian, boys, I'd best call Sergeant Clune.
Who was he, Rich?
I don't know. Never saw him before.
Well, then why should he ask to speak to you?
I don't know.
Sullivan's Royal Hotel, please.
Would you mind, Sean? I gotta speak to Tom privately.
Privately?
Yeah.
Rich, are you sure you don't need a friend to confide in?
No, thanks, Sean. Hello, I'd like to speak to Tom Evans in room 211, please. Did he say when he was coming back? No, no message. I'll call back later. Thanks.
Oh, Evans, as soon as you've changed, report back to me. Sergeant Clune's on his way over here to ask you some questions.
Yes, sir.
No. Understand. He spoke to a boy at the school before he died. Yes. It was Evans' brother.
Don't know the man who was shot.
That's right, sir.
Then how do you account for the fact that he asked to speak to you?
Well, I guess I can't account for it.
According to the identification we found on the body, he was an American, a Mr. Ralph Stafford. Does that name mean anything to you?
No, sir.
Oh, come on, Evans. You're speaking to a representative of the law.
I know that, sir, but the fact is, I've never even heard of a Mr. Stafford.
Exactly what did Mr. Stafford say to you before he died?
Well, I couldn't understand just what he said, sir.
Not a word?
No, sir.
Are you quite sure of that?
Yes, sir.
There'll be a coroner's inquest, at which time you will be placed under oath and made to answer the questions put to you. I have no further questions for the lad at present, Mr. Hoth. Good day.
Mr. Hoth?
Yes?
Oh, I'm Jim Everest. I'm with the American Embassy in Dublin.
How do you do? You're excused, Evans.
Oh, just a moment. Are you Richard Evans?
Yes, sir, I am.
Oh, you're the young man I came to see.
Me? What for?
Well, we received the message concerning Mr. Stafford's death. That was regrettable. Very regrettable. I've been sent down by the embassy to escort you to Dublin. There are certain questions that we'd like to ask you.
Can't you ask him here?
I'm afraid not. The ambassador's aide would like to speak to you personally.
All right, sir.
Are you packed?
Yes, sir. My suitcase is at the dorm.
Good. Let's go.
Oh, Mr. Everest, I wonder, would you take a friend of Richard's with you? They have tickets for a hurling match tomorrow.
Oh, very well. I suppose it'll be all right. Good day, Mr. Hoth.
Thank you.
This is Mr. Ainsworth. He's with the embassy, too.
You're going the wrong way.
On the contrary, Master Evans, we are going the right way.
Hey, what's this all about?
Neither of you has anything to worry about, as long as Master Evans chooses to cooperate. Now you will both put these on until we reach our destination. I advise you to cooperate. Now I suggest that you make yourselves comfortable. We have a long ride ahead of us.
Boy.
We have to bring him along in order to avoid suspicion.
How much does he know?
Nothing.
What have you told him?
About what?
All right. Sit him down.
You are Richard Evans?
Listen, we have a complete dossier on you as well as your brother. You were born in Philadelphia. You moved to Washington when you were 8 years old. You went to Ridgewood Military Academy. After graduation, you came here to Ireland as an exchange student. You arrived here exactly 4 months ago on the 21st of January.
Look, who are you? What do you want with me?
Your brother is an agent for the United States government. This is your brother.
Look, there's got to be a mix-up someplace. Tom's a sales representative for a steel company.
That is what he would like us both to believe. He was sent here with Ralph Stafford by the United States government to meet someone. Stephen Voss, the foremost nuclear physicist of my country. You Americans have labeled Voss a defector. We prefer to call him a traitor.
I've never heard of him.
Didn't Stafford mention his name to you before he died?
No, sir, he didn't.
Stafford made the arrangements for bringing Voss into this country. He and your brother were to meet him and arrange to have him flown by Air Force jet to the United States. We want to know how he is to be brought in and when. You are going to help us.
How do you expect me to know? I told you, I don't know anything.
Stafford spoke to you just before he died. I want to know exactly what he told you.
He didn't tell me anything. He tried to, but he died before he had a chance.
I'm waiting to hear the truth.
I'm telling you the truth.
Levick, go into the village, get Dr. Malveni. Tell him to bring me him sodium pentothal.
Do you know what is sodium pentothal? A truth serum. After one injection, we shall know if you are telling the truth.
Come on, John!
You have answered for me one very important question. Tie them, gag them, take them to the next room. After the boy has had his injection, bring him back here to me.
Here are his personal effects.
Is this everything?
Yes, everything, Mr. Evans.
Where's gloves?
There weren't any.
Where'd you say the body was found?
Leinster School.
Leinster School?
Yes, Mr. Evans.
Thanks.
Nothing.
Thank you. It's them.
Get them.
Why are you shooting?
They have escaped.
Kill them. I don't want them hurt.
What'd you say to him?
Told him to go like a rat up a drain pipe.
Look out!
Where did they go?
They came this way. They can't have gone far.
Then they must have been on the truck.
Afternoon with his friend Sean, with a Mr. Everest from your embassy.
Can I use your telephone?
Of course.
Yes, I'd like the American embassy in Dublin. Would you hurry up the call, please? It's urgent. Thank you. Yeah, this
is Tom Evans. I'd like to talk to my brother, Richard. He was brought there this afternoon by one of your people, a Mr. Everest. You sure? Right, thanks. There's no official at the embassy by the name of Everest.
You wait here.
You're in a desperate hurry to death.
I didn't think you were coming.
Thank you.
Well, Rich?
Huh?
We've been good pals right along. Ever since you first came to Leinster School, true?
Well, yeah.
And how many times did you say I took you out to the hurling field to try and teach you a thing or two about the game?
Well, lots of times. Okay, Sean, what is it?
You still say your brother works for a steel company.
Well, that's what I thought.
And you still say Mr. Stafford didn't tell you anything.
Look, Sean, I don't know any more about what's going on than you do. I'm just hoping that Tom can explain what this is all about. Don't look now. I think that guy up there is watching us. The one with the beard.
Watching us?
Yeah, through the rearview mirror. Something else I noticed, too. He hasn't turned a page of that newspaper since he sat down.
Do you, suppose he's one of them?
I don't know. I'll tell you for sure now. He was the one behind the desk, the one who asked all the questions.
How do you know?
That ring he's wearing.
What are we gonna do? Himself sitting there proud as life, he's probably carrying a gun as big as a cannon.
I'll be back in a minute. We decided to get off at the next stop, sir. I'm gonna call my brother and have him meet us there. I was just wondering, about how long will it be before we get there?
I'd say close to 20 minutes.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, there'll be a shilling refund. There you are.
Thank you. Look, we'll wait as long as we can.
Okay.
We decided to go on, sir. Here's your money back.
Well, suit yourselves, lads.
Hey, what if he telephones ahead and there's some of his men waiting for us?
Yeah, I thought of that, too. We just have to get off before that. I'll call Tom and have him pick us up.
Yeah. You know, Rich, all of this is really quite exciting. But if I were to tell it, I doubt if anybody would believe me.
Except for one person.
Who?
Me. We're gonna get off here, sir.
What'd you be making up your minds now?
This time it's for real.
Ah, well, here's your refund, sixpence.
Thank you, sir. There's a pub. We can call from there.
Okay.
Connect me with the Sullivan's Royal Hotel. I'd like to speak to Tom Evans.
Hey, Rich. It's himself.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, something I can do for you, sir.
I'm looking for a couple of young boys.
Oh, aye. They're on the phone down there.
Hear what's happened to
Where
us.
Have you two been? I've spent half the night looking for
You're
you.
You're not going to believe this, Tom.
I just save it till we get up to my room. You can tell me everything from scratch.
Some guy was following us.
He even seemed to know everything about me from the time I was born.
Yeah, and you too, Tom. He claimed you're an American agent.
Said you came here to meet a defector. A A man. What was his name, Sean?
Volos, something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, Volos. Said you and Mr. Stafford were supposed to meet him, take him to the United States.
You believe all that, Rich?
After what Sean and I have been through, what do you expect me to believe? That you're not an American agent? All right. And maybe you don't want to know what Stafford told me just before he died.
All right, if Stafford had a message for me, let me have it.
I don't know what it means. But he said my room, the Andiron, Boyne Castle. The information's there, everything. That's all he said, then he died.
That's all I need. Can you describe the man who asked you all those questions?
Shining a light in my eyes the whole time.
Well, we did see him again in the bus.
How do you know it was the same man?
It was a ring he was wearing. Black with a silver crest.
What did he look like, any of these people?
He seemed much older. He had a beard and wore dark glasses. And he walked with a cane. We didn't get a very close look at him, though. Do you know who he is, Tom?
It's the man I think he is. He's the head of the secret police behind the Iron Curtain. We only know him as Kirshner.
It'd take a pretty big deal to get him all the way out here, wouldn't it?
Yeah. The only thing is that your description doesn't match what intelligence has on him. Looks like he's using a disguise. This whole thing's liable to blow up any time now. That's why I'm sending you two to London.
London?
Yeah, with what you both know, I can't risk letting him get his hands on you again.
What are you going to be doing?
I'm going to go to Boyne Castle. I'll let your parents know about the trip, Sean. I'll arrange for the tickets and have a man from the embassy drop you off at the airport.
Come on, Tom.
That's it, Rich.
Better hurry, boys.
DEA.
Goodbye. Good luck.
Announce the departure of flight 892 to London.
Thank you.
From gate number one.
Hey, Rich, look. That's one of the men we saw last night.
Come on, we gotta get out of here. Let's go.
They must be forward.
You'll have to be seated. We're taking off shortly.
Relax. They can't go anywhere.
We'd better get back to the hotel and catch Tom before he leaves.
Right.
Checked out a few minutes ago.
I'll bet anything those two guys were tailing Tom. Sean, do you know the way to Boyne Castle?
Yeah, there's only the one main highway going north to County Mayo.
Come on, we gotta catch up to Tom before those guys do.
double room, miss. Certainly, sir. Sign just there, sir, please. Room 55, through that door, sir. It's the last room on your left at the end of the hall.
You will come with us, Mr. Evans, please. Quietly.
Look, there's Tom's car. That's the car that followed him.
Yeah.
You, gentlemen.
We're looking for my brother, Mr. Evans.
Mr. Evans? Not known Mr. Evans registered here.
Well, his car's parked outside.
Is he alone?
Yes.
Oh, you must mean the American.
He joined, Yes, Mr. Fredericks and his friends in room 55. That way.
Thank you, sir.
It's me. Yes. No. He offered no resistance.
Excellent. He will be there in 12 minutes. Don't make Mr. Evans too comfortable.
Her voice, it was chanting melodious. She left me. My heart is soothing.
See if you can get him to come to the door.
With her custody, I did tell you.
Clean up service, sir.
Get rid of him.
Let's go. Trying to make Kirshner think we're heading back. Now, do you want to tell me why you two aren't in London?
Well, we got on the airplane, just like you said.
And one of the men we saw at that house got on the plane, too. He was with another man.
So we got off again to the first class section without them seeing us.
That still doesn't explain what you're doing here.
We went back to your hotel and we saw those two guys were at the inn driving off. I just figured they were following you.
So you came up here to let me know about it, huh? Well, I appreciate it, fellas, but what am I going to do with you? Well, I can't very well send you back now.
Well, we could go with you.
It looks Looks like I have no other choice, but let's get one thing straight. You're gonna follow orders. If we get separated, we'll meet at Boyne Castle. Is that clear?
Okay.
All right, let's go.
Disney presents
The Wonderful World of Color.
Last week, Richard Evans, an American exchange student in Ireland, received a mysterious message for his brother Tom.
Boyne Castle. My room. The Andiron. The information's there. Everything.
An official of the American Embassy is sent to escort Rich and his Irish school chum Sean O'Connor to Dublin. However, the boys soon discover themselves in the hands of imposters and are taken before a very well-informed stranger.
Your brother is an agent for the United States government. This is your brother.
Look, there's got to be a mix-up someplace. Tom's a sales representative for a steel company.
He was sent here with Ralph Stafford by the United States government to meet someone. Stephen Voss. The foremost nuclear physicist in my country. You Americans have labeled Volos a defector. We prefer to call him a traitor.
Well, I've never heard of him.
Didn't Stafford mention his name to you before he died?
No, sir, he didn't.
Stafford made the arrangements for bringing Volos into this country. He and your brother were to meet him and arrange to have him flown by Air Force jet to the United States. We want to know how he is to be brought in and when. You are going to help us.
How do you expect me to know? I told you, I don't know anything.
Now understanding the importance of the dying man's message, Rich and Sean finally manage to free themselves and escape. Captors give chase, and it's soon apparent that our boys are caught up in an entire network of spies. After several close calls, they're able to catch up with Tom in Dublin and bring him up to date.
Can you describe the man who asked you all those questions?
It was a ring he was wearing. Black with a silver crest.
What did he look like, any of these people?
He seemed much older. He had a beard and wore dark glasses. Do you know who he is, Tom?
It's the man I think he is. He's the head of the secret police behind the Iron Curtain. We only know him as Kirshner.
Before Tom can start off for Boyne Castle, he's captured by some of the same gang that held the boys. He's both surprised and pleased when Rich and Sean come to his rescue. And come together, they narrowly escape the spy.
Well, I can't very well send you back now.
Well, we could go with you.
Well, looks like I have no other choice, but let's get one thing straight. If we get separated, we'll meet at Boyne Castle. Is that clear?
Okay.
Curran, Tom.
I don't think we can risk it. It won't take Curzon long to figure out we gave him the slip back there.
Yeah, but it wouldn't take long to eat breakfast either.
The way you two eat, we'd be there for hours. You can still eat a horse.
Well, I was thinking more along the lines of ham and eggs and biscuits and jam and orange juice.
Yeah, I must admit I'm a bit famished myself.
Yeah, I'm afraid this is one trip you're going to have to make on empty stomachs.
You mean all the way to County Mayo?
There's one thing we got going for us. Curzon doesn't know where we're heading. As long as we can stay one jump ahead of him, we can keep it that way. Looks like we lost that jump I was talking about.
Stem, all right. What are we gonna do?
We're gonna try and outrun him.
They have seen us.
No, no. We will never get the information we need. Closer. Give me your map. We will never find them in the dark. Now we are here, you two cover here, and here we will search here. We should have them in our hands by morning. I want that car destroyed in the event they come back to it.
Thank you.
get into the car. And hurry.
Did you guys wait here? I'll get the tickets.
Yeah. Do you think we lost him?
Don't know, but I have the strangest feeling they're about here someplace.
Yeah, so do I.
I'm gonna find out if the dining car is open and get something to eat.
Start searching now. I'm hurrying.
Two of them on the way back here.
Inside.
We've searched every car. There's no sign of them.
They must be on the train. I saw them get on myself.
But we've already...
Find them.
Jump. Pick a soft spot, and when you hit the ground, roll, okay?
Okay. Okay.
You guys okay?
Great.
You can speak for yourself.
Do you know the area around here, Sean?
Yeah, I've passed through it a few times by car.
Well, how do we get to the road to Longford?
Should be over there somewhere. I'm not sure how far.
Let's go.
Hey,
At the rate of speed we're going, I think we'd have made better time walking.
What are we going to do when we get to Longford, Tom?
Well, the first thing I'm going to do is talk to the constable and see if he can arrange some transportation for the rest of our trip.
Well, while you're doing that, I think maybe Sean and I will try to dig up something to eat.
No, I'm afraid not, Rich. We can't risk you guys being seen.
Easy there. Over you go. Oh. Well, did you ever see the like of that? The next thing you know, these city boys will be taking over Ireland in its entirety, with very little regard for the common folk. I can't say that I blame you for taking cover. That car had come a small bit closer, all our buddies would have been decorating the side of the road. Here, go on, go on.
Well, looks like Kersner left two men with a car. Does that train stop at Longford, Sean?
Yeah.
Well, we can expect him to be there when we get there. Rich, I want you and Sean to wait here for me in the ruins of that old abbey till I get back. If I'm not back in about half an hour or so, you'll know I didn't get past Kersner and his men, okay?
What do you want us to do if that happens?
They won't be so concerned with catching you two if they get their hands on me. So I want you to go to Boyne Castle, go to Stafford's room and get whatever information he left there, and call it in to a Mr. Mannering at the American Embassy in Dublin. Then I want it destroyed. Is that clear?
Hey, Tom, be careful, huh?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Smell it too, Rich.
Yeah, what is it?
No mistake in kidney pie.
Sure smells good.
You suppose?
We wouldn't be exactly disobeying orders.
No, that's just what I think of myself.
There it is.
Think we should?
Yeah.
Well, there you go, Rich. We'll have to forsake our manners.
Sir, have you any assistance at all?
Yeah, I need some transportation.
Transportation? Ah, well, no, sir, that's a problem.
Well, I have a letter here from your deputy prime minister identifying me.
That's right, sir. Well, no. Well, see, the only car we have at the moment is Kelleher, and he's beyond the station and waiting for the Dublin train. Now,
he has got to be found.
How long's he been gone?
About 20 minutes.
Get back to the houses.
Hiding in the church. At least we separated them from Evans.
Beyond those fields are marshlands. We should have little trouble finding them out there.
Yes, we do now, Rich. We can't go back there.
We're going on to Boyne Castle, just like Tom told us.
Well, if we're going, we'd best get moving. A nice walk to the next village.
Say we rest.
Well, as you know, Rich, I'm not given to argument, especially when it comes to food or rest.
I sure hope Tom got away. You know, I bet you he's waiting right there when we get to Boyne Castle. You ever been there, Sean? Sean? Sean, do you hear that?
Oh, likely it's the Master Connors.
The what?
Oh, the Master of Foxhounds out in an early morning hunt.
Well, it sounds like they're coming this way.
Second thought, Rich, they don't sound like foxhounds. The baying's different.
What do you mean different?
My father once owned a pair of bloodhounds, and their baying sounded like that when they were on the scent.
Bloodhounds? Hey, you don't think that...
I think we'd best be on our way, and quick.
Hey,
us, Rich. They're bound to catch us.
Well, what are we going
to
do?
We'll have to try and fool them.
How?
Look, you hide there in the water. Now I'll make a circle, try and throw the dogs off the track, and then double back.
You think it'll work?
Well, it's our only chance.
Yeah.
Then there'll be no trail for the dogs to follow.
It doesn't matter now. They can't have gone far.
Here, quick. Dogs.
It worked. Come on, this way.
Ignition. What is it you want?
Do you know anywhere we can rent a car?
Car? Well, now, mind you, I'm not in the business of renting cars, but I won't be using my own.
Is this your car?
It is. It's a fine car. They don't make them like this anymore.
Yeah, but the tires are all flat.
Ah, pumping a little bit of muscle else, you'll be riding high. Well, does it run? Does it run? Like silk if treated decent. How far are you going?
We're going to County Mayo.
I'll charge you by the mile. 7 and 6 for every 10 miles you put on the speedometer.
That's a bit steep, isn't it?
Well, take it or leave it. It's my final ward.
I'll take it.
I'll treat her like you would your own. You'll have no trouble. Be back about 2:30. I'll have a tune for you.
Thanks a lot.
Leave us about 3 hours.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking, Rich?
Food.
Well, there's an inn here called the Ram's Head, and they have roast beef, the like of which you've never seen before in your life.
No, be a kind of Martian.
Oh, no, Blas Morgan. All right, what are you talking about?
Private conversation.
I understand. Just leave me out of it.
No, he wouldn't do that.
Wouldn't we?
He's trying to tell me I'm the only colleen in the whole of Ireland.
No, it was a compliment. I meant it.
That's enough of that. Would you be caring for dessert?
Oh, I don't know. I'm kind of full.
Our speciality for today is deep dish apple pie.
Well, maybe just a little tiny piece.
Well, you can make that too.
Excuse me.
I've been meaning to ask. You're American, aren't you?
Why, does it show?
I suppose it's the way you talk. What do you think of Ireland?
Well,
it must be awfully exciting compared to America.
No, I wouldn't exactly say that.
I'll be fetching your pie now.
Well, now, Rich, you never told me you had an eye for the girls. It appears you've melted her poor heart like a lump of tallow you have.
The operator's got your call through.
Thank you. Hello, Lord Boyne. I'm sorry to bother you, sir, but my name is Richard Evans. I was just wondering if my brother Tom has arrived there yet. Well, yes, sir, he's a friend of Mr. Stafford's. Then would you mind leaving a message for him? Just tell him that Sean and I are okay and we should be there by sometime this afternoon. Thank you, sir.
What?
He hasn't gotten there yet.
Yeah, well, knowing Tom, I wouldn't worry. Bet you he'll be there when we arrive.
Is that the smallest piece you have?
I've always been told you Americans have big appetites.
Yeah, I guess that rumor has gotten around. By the way, do you know if there are any rooms available?
Number 10 is vacant. Would you be staying long?
Just a couple of hours.
You'd rent a room for a couple hours?
It's just that we're a little bit behind in our sleep.
Seems a waste of good money just for a wee nap.
Would you wake us up at 2 o'clock, please?
2 o'clock it is.
Oh, by the way, if anybody comes looking for us, will you let us know?
Yes, I will.
Thanks.
Exchange, please. Wireless operator.
Keep them there until we arrive. Use force if necessary. I'm no longer interested in playing games with children. They are still heading northwest. Spanish Point. Blackhead. Liscano Bay.
cannot understand what in you were here. I thought...
I'm not concerned with what you thought. You have allowed two children to get away from you.
It doesn't matter. I think I know where they're going.
Where?
I overheard one of them speaking on the telephone. I heard him say that he and his young friend were to meet Agent Evans with a Lord Boyne.
We have been going about this in the wrong way. We will get the information we need. And this time, they will come to us.
Yeah, how much?
Must be going to a fire.
Yeah, must be. Is it a back road to County Mayo?
Back road?
Yeah, we'd like to stay off the main highway. My friend here would like to see some of the countryside.
Straight down the road to Hogan's Woods. Take a left and then there's freewheeling all the way. Hey, lads, I'll need a deposit.
That'd be enough.
Suppose it'll do.
Well, good luck, lads.
We have been expecting you, Mr. Evans. You have given us a lot of trouble. Too much trouble.
Where do we go from here, Kersner?
How do you know who I am?
That beard only changed your looks, not your methods.
You are not going anywhere. You will simply wait here with us. Your brother and his young friend will be here very soon. They will give us the information we need. Put him with the others.
You are pushing people about like that, you oversized bully.
Keep quiet, old man.
Quiet, is it you're telling me? In my own castle.
Please don't, my lord.
Mark my words, we'll get the lot of you before you can leave County Mayo. That you can be certain.
There really is no way out, Mr. Evans. You may as well make yourself comfortable. You'll be here for quite a while. You may even die here.
do you do, Mr. Evans? I'm Lord Boyd.
How do you do, sir?
Your brother telephoned. He was safe then, but he's coming here this afternoon.
That's what I'm worried about. Is there any way out of here?
I'm afraid not, Mr. Evans.
Hello? No one there. Well, there it is, Rich. Boyne Castle.
Kind of a lonely looking place, isn't it?
Well, one thing I'll wager on. Mr. Cursor himself wouldn't get at us behind those walls.
Presents
The Wonderful World of Color.
In our last two episodes, we met Richard Evans, an American exchange student in Ireland, as he received a mysterious message for his older brother, Tom.
You must tell no one else. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Boyne Castle. My room. The Andiron. The information's there. Everything. Tell Tom.
In trying to get the message to his brother, Rich and his school chum, Sean O'Connor, are captured and questioned.
Your brother is an agent for the United States government. This is your brother.
Look, there's got to be a mix-up someplace. Tom's a sales representative for a steel company.
He was sent here with Ralph Stafford by the United States government to meet someone. Stephen Ross. The foremost nuclear physicist of my country. You Americans have labeled Volos a defector. We prefer to call him a traitor.
I've never heard of him.
Didn't Stafford mention his name to you before he died?
No, sir, he didn't.
Stafford made the arrangements for bringing Volos into this country. He and your brother were to meet him and arrange to have him flown by Air Force jet to the United States. We want to know how he is to be brought in and when. You are going to help.
The boys escape and find themselves being chased by a large network of international spies. They finally catch up with Rich's brother, and the three of them set off for Boyne Castle with the spies close behind. After several close calls, the boys and Tom are separated. Each team heads for Boyne Castle. Tom arrives first.
We have been expecting you, Mr. Evans. You have given us a lot of trouble. Too much trouble.
Where do we go from here, Kirchner?
You will simply wait here with us. Your brother and his young friend will be here very soon.
How do you do, sir? I'm Richard Evans. Has my brother arrived yet?
No, he has not.
Well, this is my friend from school, Sean O'Connor.
And O'Connor's always welcome here.
Thank you, sir.
Although I'm surprised you got here at all, right in this monstrosity. It looks about to explode at any moment.
Well, I wouldn't bet against it, sir.
Should we go inside? Barely here will bring your luggage.
Well, I'm afraid we don't have any, sir.
Oh, have you not? Now, how's that?
Well, we lost it on the trip.
Well, isn't that unfortunate? Never mind. Barely here will find your change of clothes. Mind you, don't guarantee they'll fit.
I guess we could use a change, sir.
Good. You'll see to that. Won't you, Bailey?
Yes, my lord.
Come along, then. Well, now, tell me, what are you two young lads doing here at Boyne Castle?
Well, actually, we're just supposed to be my brother. I'm not for sure he'd show up by now.
Ah, where's he coming from, then?
Well, he was staying at Sullivan's. We saw him there yesterday.
Ah, is that right?
You're sure he hasn't phoned or anything?
But nothing's got through to me. Is it urgent? I mean, what's your problem?
He's coming to pick up Mr. Stafford's belongings.
His belongings?
Mr. Stafford won't be coming back here.
What do you mean? Where's he gone, then?
Well, he's dead, sir.
Dead? Well, how did that happen?
A car accident.
Well, I'm very sorry to hear that. He was a fine gentleman. Fine gentleman.
No, it's almost like you'd expect to find King Arthur in the Knights of the Round Table here.
Well, may I remind you, Rich, that King Arthur was an Englishman. And hardly very welcome on Irish soil.
You know your history, lad. If you care to freshen up before you have your dinner, I'll show you your room.
Thank you, sir.
This way, then. Here you are, lads. Right along here. This is your room. I hope you'll be very comfortable.
Excuse me, sir. Which was Mr. Stafford's room?
Which one? That one. Over there. There now. Bailey will be along shortly with your change of clothes. And we usually start serving dinner about 8 o'clock.
Thank you, sir.
Why'd you tell him Mr. Stafford died in a car accident?
I just thought maybe Tom wouldn't want us telling any more than we have to anybody.
Are you going to check Stafford's room now?
No, I think we better wait till Tom gets here.
Look, I don't like to say this, Rich, but what if Tom doesn't get here? Remember, he did say that if we got here first, you were to get the message to Mr. Mannering at the embassy.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I'll be right back.
Thank you.
there was outside the window.
Who?
I don't know, but it looks like to me somebody in this castle could be working for Kirstner.
Well, what are we going to do?
Just don't let on that we suspect anything. And hope Tom shows up pretty soon. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Mr. Evans, there's something I must tell you. I hope you enjoy your dinner, sir.
Ah, there you are, lads. Are the clothes a decent fit?
Well, they're fine, thank you very much.
Ah, that's grand.
It's better than what we had.
I hope you've an appetite for your dinner.
Yes.
I know I have for mine.
We usually do.
It'll be a simple meal, but please God, there'll be enough of it.
Ah, doesn't that smell grand? Serve our guest first, if you please, Sarah.
Yes, my lord.
I trust you have no objection to oxtail soup.
No, sir, it's my favorite.
That's grand.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, my lord.
It's okay.
Never mind, Sarah, never mind. But we wouldn't like our guests to think we were country clods, now, would we?
No, my lord.
Both doing quite well so far. But I would not want any slips. You understand?
Yes.
If you forgive my curiosity, I was just wondering if your brother's visit had anything to do with Mr. Stafford's mission in County Mayo.
Well, I don't know, sir.
Thank you, Sarah. That'll do. You see, it was the Deputy Prime Minister himself who called and asked me to let Mr. Stafford have a room here. Now, he said that it was quite important that we cooperate with Mr. Stafford, and he even intimated that the nature of his work was, now, what did he call it now? Top secret. Would that be it?
Well, I wouldn't know about that, sir.
Did your brother work for Mr. Stafford, then?
Well, yes, sir. I think they were with the same company.
Ah, is that right? Mr. Stafford did mention to me that he was expecting to meet somebody here in the county. And quite soon. Of course, it's very difficult for me to imagine who he was expecting to meet, but I would venture to guess he's somebody quite important. I mean, judging by the air of mystery surrounding his arrival, you know.
How do you like it, Rich? Soup, how do you like it?
Oh, it's fine.
Myself, I can see something strange about Lord Boyne's brogue.
Want to know why?
Yeah, why?
He's not Lord Boyne.
What do you mean?
Remember, I talked to Lord Boyne on the telephone. He hardly had any brogue at all. I don't know why I didn't catch that before.
Yeah, I should have known. So he speaks to the brogue of the country people, not the nobility.
Not only that, but he knows way too much about what Mr. Stafford was doing here. Stafford never would have told him he came here to meet someone. Besides that, Tom said the only other person who knew anything about this at all was Mr. Mannering.
Well, then he must be one of them, Rich.
Well, who else could he be? You know, something else. Bailey was going to tell me something just before whoever that guy is came in tonight.
Yeah, Sarah seemed afraid, too. Do you get the feeling that all of a sudden that we're in a prison instead of a castle?
Yeah.
Well, what are we doing?
We're going to get out of here. You know, I've been thinking. Suppose Tom did get here. Could be they've locked him up someplace in this castle. I know it's risky, but I'm going to check Stafford's room again and try to get a call through to Mr. Mannering at the embassy. You keep watch in case anybody comes.
Mm-hmm.
the American Embassy in Dublin, please. So wait. Hello, I'd like to speak to Mr. Mannering, please. He's not in. When do you expect him back? Would you give him this message, please? Tell him it's very important.
Tell him Mr. Volos is arriving at Westport, aboard the cargo ship, the Shannon. It's going to dock tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock.
Thank you for the information, Master Evans. Thank you. Bring him here immediately. Go for the other boy.
Hello? Hello?
Come on, Rich. They're coming.
Your message to your embassy was most informative. I am very anxious to see Volos' face when he discovers me waiting for him.
What are you going to do with it?
Shall we simply say that he will not be returning with us?
You're the man who asked all the questions. The man on the bus. Well, you're...
Yes.
Why all the disguise?
American intelligence has a complete description of me. I cannot leave my own country unless I take certain precautions.
How did you know we were coming to Boncastle?
Your friend's telephone call to Lord Boyne was overheard by one of many. You really must learn to exercise more caution. Even your brother walked in here totally unprepared.
Where is Tom?
You shall be taken to him immediately.
You two okay?
Yeah, we're just great. Lord Boyne?
That's right.
I'm afraid you really thought he was you at first, sir.
No, don't worry. It's not your fault. Does Kirzner know anything?
Knows everything. It's just like you told me, Tom. When you didn't show up, I got the message from Stafford's room and called it into the embassy. Kirzner listened in on the call.
Yeah, I fell in the same trap myself. When is Volos getting in?
Tomorrow on a cargo ship.
Well, isn't there any way out of here, Tom?
Only through that door, and it'd take a tank to put a dent in it.
Well, are none of these guns any good?
Antiques. Don't worry.
I've just got an idea how we can get out of here. Now, I don't know if it'll work, but I think it's worth a try.
Well, let's hear it. We haven't got much time.
Well, did Rich ever tell you he won the javelin championships in school?
Yeah, he mentioned it. Why?
Oh, it was a great throw. It was about 190 feet or something.
Yeah, 194.6.
But you're not going to argue over fractions.
Well, it was 190.
Well, wait a minute. Now, what does this have to do with getting us out of here?
Well, we need rope.
Rope?
Rope.
I don't know what you want it for, but there's some holding up that tapestry.
Yeah, that should do it.
Do what?
Well, see, we can tie one end of the rope to this.
Yeah?
Now, Rich can toss it through that window. And if he can get it to wedge itself against the wall outside, all one of us has to do is to climb up the rope. Well, that's if you don't mind us taking down your tapestry, sir.
No, sir, so. I only hope your plan works.
Yeah, so do I.
Don't worry, we'll have you out of here in no time.
You will remain here. If anyone comes, meet them outside the gatehouse. Say Lord Boyne is gone for the day. Allow no one to enter the castle under any circumstances. Is that clear?
All right, get the car now. We go to meet the boat very soon. As soon as Volos is in our hands, I return with him here.
Why you? Directly beneath this floor is an old dungeon. There are boxes and crates there as dry as can. We shall take all our prisoners down there, and there will be a fire. A fire that no one in this castle shall survive. There will be no one left to identify us or to say that we ever have been here. No one.
Well, there you go, champ.
What'd I tell you?
I sure hope this works.
So do I, especially since it was my idea.
Goes.
can't see the gate from here.
Well, what do you think is happening?
I don't know, but we did hear that car pull out.
Well, I wouldn't like to bet they've all gone.
All right, inside.
We have a way of handling the likes of you. Have you ever felt the smart of a shillelagh across the broad of your back? Well, have you? You dirty scruffy.
Well, come along. The door is open. What are you waiting for?
We'll never be able to thank you enough for saving us.
Well, it was Rich who got the 194-6.
He's the only one left in the castle. I'd like him kept locked up here till I get back.
Of course, Mr. Evans.
Now, I have to intercept Volus. Do you have a boat or something I could use?
I have a dory docked at the beach with a path leading down to
it. Good, thank you.
And I hope you'll be very uncomfortable during your stay here.
That'll make it?
I sure hope so.
What if we don't get to the boat on time?
We?
Well, yeah.
You two are staying here. I don't know what I'll run into out there. If Kirzner finds out Volus isn't on that ship, there's no telling what he's liable to do. And no shenanigans from you two either.
Isn't that a grand sight? A Slingsby T-49 two-seater.
How do you know so much about them?
Well, I got a license to fly gliders. Round to a club in Kilkenny.
I never knew that.
Oh, well, I haven't been up since last summer. Maybe you'd like to go up sometime.
Sure. Listen, let's get back up there so we can see Tom.
Okay.
Our destination, Mr. Wallace, Westport, Northern Ireland. There'll be an American agent waiting for us there with a car to drive us to Dublin, where a jet will be standing by.
Are you sure there won't be someone else waiting there also, Mr. Carlson?
Well, now, look, I can't honestly say what might happen. Since we got you smuggled out, so far things have gone pretty smoothly.
Yeah, perhaps too smoothly.
We'll get you to the States in one piece.
Don't underestimate the opposition, Mr. Carlson. I know Mr. Kirsten's methods and resources. And I also know how effective he can be when he wants someone eliminated. It's difficult for me to believe that we have come this far unmolested.
That's one of our fellows.
Evans! Carlton, tell the captain to stop the ship!
Captain, that man in the boat is an American agent. He asks you to stop the ship. It's urgent.
What happened? You and Volos are getting out here. They know.
Come on. Ship, it stopped.
It's Evans. He's taking Volos off the boat.
It's impossible.
And explain to me what he's doing out there. We have got to overtake that boat.
Morning, sir.
Good morning. Isn't it great weather?
Joseph, good morning. I wonder if it could be possible to borrow your boat.
My boat.
Yes. We are willing to pay for the use of it.
Oh, I'm afraid that's not possible, sir. You see, I have this fishing party I'm taking out this morning.
I would not argue the point.
No, sir. No. I wasn't going to do that. But tell me, will you be leaving me both back to me?
That depends on whether you inform the police. Somehow I think that you will.
Again, coming in to make his approach.
It's a lovely sight.
He's over-ruddering. I think he's only a beginner.
It's the gliding club that uses one of my fields. Something to do with the updraft from the cliffs.
Any sign of my brother yet, sir?
I'll see him.
Mind if I have a look?
Sure.
There's his boat. Tom's okay. Looks like he's got Volos with him. Hey, let me have a look. Here. Hey, wait. Hey, Rich, you better take a look.
Why?
It's Kirsten. Catch up with him for sure in that boat. We gotta try and stop him.
Well, how?
I don't know. Maybe that glider can help us somehow.
Hey, wait a minute. I haven't flown for about a year.
But you can fly, right?
Yeah, but those cliffs are very high. And even if we do get out there, what are we supposed to do?
I don't know exactly. Come on. Why are you stopping? We're gonna bomb him with these cannonballs, if you don't mind us using a few of them, sir.
I'll give you a hand.
Do you mind attaching the tow rope, sir?
Of course. Shouldn't we get permission first?
We've no time for it. I'll speak to him once you're up.
It's his lordship.
Well, what's he doing?
It looks like they're putting cannonballs into the glider.
I suppose his lordship has... You better find out.
Yeah. Release it.
that's a really strong lift.
You sure you know how to fly this thing?
Well, we're airborne, aren't we?
You can say that again. There they are. Come on, let's go.
Yeah, Lizzie, we've got to use more lift to gain height.
Begging your pardon,
I know,
sir.
Lads, I know. I hope they get your plane back, too.
Feet, that should do it. We're going out first and then down. Get ready. We're going down.
Here goes.
Can you get this thing any lower?
Well, I tried. Surprising when you consider who's doing the flying.
Hey, Tom!
You know them, Evans?
That's my kid brother. The last thing I told him to do was stay put.
I think we should all be thankful he didn't.
Going down. Can't get my foot.
Well, it appears you have failed.
here.
I'm sinking here.
Boat. Help me get to the side. Here, help me. Close, please.
I don't get it.
What's it all about?
A man, son. One that's free at last.
I don't want you two young fellows to think I don't appreciate your sudden
appearance
over the
bay.
I just remember, we
got to get back to school.
Yeah, we've got that hurling match with some more time.
All right, if we leave right now, we can just make it. Here. Okay.